If you have children in your home, get them a surely do bad act. We have adults get them in study by it so that they get better understanding. In our daily life, we use Bible. If we use Bible, we will be blessed so much. In Deuteronomy 6:12, please open your Bible. In Deuteronomy 6:12. It took life. It indicated past God for the next generation. Deuteronomy 6:12. These commandments that I give you today and will be your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road. When you lie down and when you get up. This is God's word. Even every time, even when you sleep, even when you walk, whatever you do, meditate God's word. By doing this, these are people. They are the most number of people who were not right because of doing this work. They used to meditate God's word. 6:8, write them as symbols on your hands, bind them on your foreheads, write them on your door frames of your homes and on your gates. I want to share a small example of this. That write them on your door frame of your house and your gates. Psalms 119:11 says, it says above, I have many words in my heart, but I may not say anything to you. And for the sake of the truth, my people will be all in the same way. This word is written on the doorstep of my house. By reading this word, God, every day, I explain myself. I have to keep God's word in my heart and to think that I should not sin against God's law, I should not sin against the Bible. By this I was blessed so much in every way. By implementing this word of God in my life, I have written a word in my heart that I am not sin against. Whenever I go to praise some that does not belong to God, I used to remind this word of God and think of this word and not a sinning God's law. God's word is so much precious to us. God's word, God is saying this according to Matthew 6:26. You see words. They are looking for food, but they don't worry because God is feeding them. Heavenly Father is feeding them. Matthew 6:26. Can anyone of you by worrying add a single hour of your life? Why worry? Because our feelings are greater than the words. God will take care of us. Proverbs 27. Never goes to tomorrow. You don't know what will happen to another. Keep your whole trustworthy in you, in God, and just read your life. Isaiah 1:9. If you believe in God, best fruit, give them the best fruit of the world. The land and the places. By trusting God's word, you will get the best word in experience. John 15:1-4. It all says about God is true one, and the true one, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch of mine in me that bears no fruit, but every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes. So that it will be even more faith. If you have your phone, just set whom we are in, then it's a game. If all that is about engaging of your trick, that we will be increasing life, increasing about the sun. And if we cut a branch that bears more fruit, and it even bears much and more, and it even bears fruits. By cutting branch that bears no fruit, is no problem, but we will be getting harder. If God gives it, just allow God. And James 1:20-25, it all says about reflecting God's word in us. As you try to make a personal evaluation, some of us may have nothing to measure our attitudes, or actions against the law. We may never have a good role model to follow. Here James reminds us, God's word functions like a mirror in our life. As we read, we get a clear picture of God, how God wants us to be like. It shows us where we want to measure up God's intense work. And at last, by trusting God's word, how we can trust God's word? By believing in God and by reading scriptures. For example, we take Psalms, for instance, Psalms 1. By reading, how did it apply to me and how did it apply to Jesus? Just think about it. Jesus is the only one who does Psalms 1 chapter completely. He has now stood among sinners to engage with them. He stood among them to speak to them, but he never allowed them to infect his life. But what are you doing? We are sitting among sinners and we are just engaging them in a college or workplaces and in public. But we never sat down, but Jesus now sat down with sinners in the way they engage their life. Jesus not sat down with sinners and Jesus never mocked up people. God's life, His word, in His heart, and He is one who is like a tree planted by the streams of water and who prospers. This is the only one who makes prosper to be one. According to Matthew 5th chapter, 48 verse, be perfect, therefore, as your Heavenly Father is perfect. Try to be holy, it is unholy God. Once again, I am saying, try to be holy, it is unholy God. So, each and every one of this congregation, pray, wait at the word of God, and listen to God. And by your praying, don't make your prayer just a shopping expenditure, like asking God for this and that. Ask God for His will in you. Jeremiah 11 verse. God is having a specific plan for you. Not to harm you, not to destroy you, but to prosper you. God is having a special plan for you and for your life. Thank you.